Hello and welcome everyone. So in the previous video we talked about different middlewares. In this video we are going to create a post controller and we will create a different routes like create post, update post, delete post, and we will be using all these middlewares we have created. So let's get started. In the user we have created these two routes, but here we would be needing these middlewares to be there. So first middleware we need is check JWT, and another middleware is check is user. Okay, check is not author. So let me check what is the middleware name, so we'll import it accordingly. Check is user. Okay, we are not putting the correct name. Check is user. So these are the two middleware, check JWT and check is user, we will be using. Sometimes the auto import doesn't work and it gives us something else. Okay, now we have registered these two middlewares. It will be validating the token. It will be validating that you are not the one who is updating it. I mean, if you are updating or deleting, then this is put, right? So you should be able to update yourself. You should be able to delete yourself. So sometimes we see in different web application where you can delete your account, deactivate your account, update your profile. So all these should be allowed only if you are the logged in user, right? So this check is user is checking that the current logged in user should be the same user which we are getting in the request.params. Okay, now what we will do, we'll create another route which is post.ts. That will be taking care of all the operation for the post. So we'll copy and paste it here. What we are going to change is entity will be post. Okay, we are not using entity anywhere, so it will be just a post controller that we are going to create. So post controller will have all these methods, simply like router.get post controller dot list all, get one by id simply if you wanted to get, and then here we can create a new post, post controller dot that we are going to create. Here we are just giving the names, new post, but before doing this we would be validating the token, check JWT. This is the middleware we are passing. Another thing is, if you wanted to update a particular post, then we will be checking two different things. First of all, check JWT and check author. His author means only the author should be allowed to update his post. So here we will be having one method is edit post, which we will be creating. Similarly here also check is author and post controller dot delete post. Okay, sounds cool. Now we can create post controller and start defining all these methods. Plain and simple. So in the post controller, I will just start with the basic methods. What all methods we are going to have is class export class post controller. Why? Export class post controller. And in this post controller, we will define all our methods. So like first method I'm creating is list all, and what it is doing is it will be just making a call. We have same request response. And next from next function. Every time it gives me the wrong input. Here we are getting request response comma next function. Cool. So here we'll be just doing the same. Post repo we'll get post repo, and we'll be doing get repository from type ORM, and we'll be passing our entity which is post. So we can import the post entity quickly. Now once we got the post entity repo, we would be able to make a request away post repo dot find, and I think this will work. And what we need to do, response dot status 200.json. I mean, I'm just sending a different message payload format, but it should be not like this. You can use some kind of a response template, so you would be sending a consistent way of returning the messages here. I mean it's just a simple read operation, so there are less chances to get an error. But to handle error, you can just do this next error. Anything wrong here? It should be next. Okay, so same method. Now we have written one method. We don't need to do a lot of repetitions. We can just do get one by ID. So we'll be getting the request.params.id, right? So it will be the straightforward find one or fail, which we discussed in the user controller also. So first of all, what we can do is const id equal to request.params.id. Okay, you got the id. Now you would be able to just trigger few queries. I can just format it. Configure the formatter. Format document. So here we can configure the TypeScript formatter, and this is fine. We just convert it into a number. Now this will work, right? So it is giving us get one post by ID. Now another thing we can do is we can write another method, which is creating the post. So rest all the methods we'll cover in the next video.